Hello, my name is Dr. Abraham Yan, and in this channel, I go over problem-solving strategies, mainly as it relates to math competitions. This is a problem from the International Math Competition for University Students. This is problem number 7 from IMC 2025. Find all non-empty subsets of positive integers satisfying both of the following properties. If x is in M, then 2x is in M, and if x and y are in M and x plus 1 is even, then x plus y over 2 is also in M. So I'm going to walk you through the process by which I obtain the solution. The first step is to figure out some examples of sets that satisfy this property. So first, let's see what these two conditions are. So the first one tells you that if x is in that set, then 2x must be in that set as well. And if x and y are in that set, then the midpoint x plus y over 2 would have to also be in that set. So the first thing is, if you look at all integers, all positive integers, this would be, and I'm going to use z plus for positive integers. This is an example of a set satisfying this condition. But of course, that's not the only one. We could easily find others. For example, the set 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. In fact, if you take any integer n, n plus 1, n plus 2, etc., this would be an example of a set satisfying this these two conditions. So then I thought, okay, that's probably the answer to the problem. Let's go ahead and prove that, in fact, every set would have to be of this form. So then I started like playing with these two conditions. And this, along with problems in functional equations, have similar strategy. Play with these conditions, keep track of what you are able to prove, and then see if you can generalize things, and then see if you can find out the function, or in this case, the set. So first thing is, I know that x is in the set M, so that tells us that 2x is in the set M, that tells us that 4x is in the set M, so I can take the average of these two, so I get 2x plus 4x over 2, that is in M, so that gives us that 3x is in M. So then I thought I can perhaps repeatedly apply this and get that every nx is in N. So can I prove that nx is in M, if x is in M? Okay, so I can apply induction for that. I know that this is true for 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I've proved it for these four numbers. Now let's look at n plus 1 is in M. So I know that n plus 1 x is in M. So I know that nx is in M, n plus 1 x, I want to show that n plus 1 x is in M. So if 2 divides n plus 1, then I know that n plus 1 over 2 is in x is in M by inductive hypothesis. So then I can just multiply this by 2 and I get 2 times n plus 1 over 2 times x is in M. So I'm done. If 2 doesn't divide n plus 1, then I can write down n plus 1 as 2m plus 1. And then I can write down 2m plus 1x as mx plus m plus 1x. And this is just the average of 2mx and 2 times m plus 1x, which would have to be in M because I know both of these two are in M. Therefore, their doubles are also in M. So I was able to prove that if x is in M, then nx is in M for every x, for every positive integer n. So it looks like we're getting kind of closer to the solution. So now I looked at the second condition, and I saw that when I have x and y are in M, then I know that x plus y over 2 is in M, assuming that 2 divides x plus y. Well, this tells us that x plus y is also in M. So this is the property of closure. So can I prove that if x and y are in M, then x plus y is also in M? Well, I can prove this one even if 2 doesn't divide x plus y. How can I do that? I can write down x plus y as the average of 2x and 2y. And I know that both 2x and 2y are in M. So what did we show? We showed that M is closed under addition. that doesn't really mean that the set would have to be the set that we created. So I thought, okay, what are some other sets that are closed under addition, which would also imply this, by the way, this condition would be implied from closure under addition. What are some sets that are closed under addition? Well, for example, if you look at all the even numbers, 2, 4, 6, 8, etc., which we typically denote that by 2z plus, this would be closed under addition. But that doesn't satisfy the condition, because if you take 2 plus 4 over 2, this is 3, which isn't in 2z plus. Okay, so that doesn't satisfy the condition. So let's look at all the multiples of 3. 3, 6, 9, etc. This is denoted by 3z plus. Does this satisfy the condition? Well, let's see. If I look at two numbers, 3x and 3y, and if I take the average of these two, that's 3 times x plus y over 2, which would be inside 3z plus if 2 divides x plus y. So notice that 2 dividing x plus y is the same as 2 dividing 3x plus 3y. So this means it satisfies the second condition. And of course, if 3x is inside 3z plus, then double that, which would be 6x, is of course inside 3z plus. So this is interesting, because I found some additional sets that satisfy this. Now, if I replace 3 by 4, that would fail for a similar reason to what we saw up there. But if I replace 3 by 5, it would satisfy the property. So we found this nz plus, where n is odd, this also satisfies the two conditions. Okay, so this is interesting. So we got these, and the other set that we found was everything from n to infinity intersection with z plus. This also satisfies the condition. So also satisfies the two conditions that they gave us. Well, interestingly, if you take all of the multiples of n that are after a point, that also satisfies the condition. So if you look at m equals kn, k plus 1n, k plus 2n, etc., if you look at this, where k is some positive integer and n is odd, then this set also satisfies the same condition. Very similar idea, because if you take ln plus mn divided by 2, since n is odd, this is l plus m over 2, this would be inside m, if 2 divides l plus m, which is the exact same thing as 2 divides nl plus nm. So it satisfies the second condition, and of course, if ln is inside nz plus, then double that is also inside nz plus. So we found an answer to the problem that we hadn't really found before. So we found a bunch of sets that didn't really satisfy our initial guess. So perhaps this would be, in fact, the answer to the problem. So let's start and see if we can prove that M is, in fact, the answer to the problem. So let M be this set, A1, A2, A3, etc. And let's assume it is in this order. So A1 is less than A2, less than A3, etc. So what I need to show is that this is an arithmetic sequence with a common difference of N that is odd. So the first thing let n be a2 minus a1. So there are two possibilities. Either n is odd or n is even. So if n is even, then I can say that a2 plus a1 is also even. And that is interesting, because that means a1 plus a2 over 2 must be in m. But that's not true, because a1 is the first term, a2 is the second term, a1 plus a2 over 2 is right in the middle. So this cannot be in m, because those are the smallest two terms of the set, two elements of the set. So this means 2 doesn't divide n. So the set is A1. The second element of the set is A1 plus n, and n is even. Now let's look at the third element of the set. So A3, we have A1 less than A2 less than A3. So in a very similar fashion, A3 minus A2 is odd, because if it is even, then the midpoint would have to be in M. The midpoint of A2 plus A3 over 2 would have to be in M, which isn't. So this would have to be odd. But if this is odd and A1 minus A2 is also odd, that would mean A1 minus A3 is even, which means A1 plus A3 is even, which would mean A1 plus A3 over 2 would have to be in M. But what is the only point between A1 and A3 that is in M? Well, that's A2. So this means A2 would have to be A1 plus A3 over 2. Okay, so now we're going to prove this claim. So the claim is AK is equal to AK minus 1 plus N for every K. We showed this one for, and of course this implies A3 is A2 plus N, because that's just the midpoint. The difference between A1 and A2 is N. The difference between A2 and A3 would have to also be N. So we're going to have to show this one by induction. So this is by induction on K. Well, we proved this one for K equals 2, and we also proved it for K equals 3. Let's prove it for every K. So let's look at AK minus 1, then AK, and then AK plus 1. We know that the difference between these two is odd. So if AK plus 1 minus AK is odd, is even, then AK plus 1 plus AK over 2 would have to be in M, which is not possible because AK plus 1 is the element of M right after AK. So that doesn't happen. So that means 2 does not divide AK plus 1 minus AK. And now since 2 also doesn't divide AK minus AK plus 1, these two are minus 1. Both of these two numbers are odd. This is odd, this is odd. So therefore their sum is even. 2 divides AK plus 1 minus AK minus 1. So this means AK plus 1 plus AK minus 1 over 2 is inside M. But there's only one element between AK minus 1 and AK plus 1. So this means AK is equal to AK plus 1 plus AK minus 1 over 2. So this tells us that AK plus 1 is twice AK minus AK minus 1, which is 2 AK minus AK minus N, which is AK plus N. So we proved our claim. So this tells us that M is equal to A1, A1 plus N, A1 plus 2N, etc. So this is our set. Now let's see if this set satisfies the two conditions. The first thing is, if something's in there, then double that would have to be in that set also. So we know that A1 is in M, so that means 2A1 would have to be in M, which means 2A1 would have to be A1 mod N, because everything in this set is A1 mod N, which means N would have to divide A1. So that tells us that M is equal to, if you write then A1 as NK, this would be equal to NK, N plus 1K, N plus, or rather N times K plus 1, N times K plus 2, etc. And that's exactly what we wanted to prove. So this is the only set that satisfies the conditions, and we also showed that N is odd. So that brings me to the end of this video. I will see you in the next video.